What's up, everybody? A Sparrow with a Gun here from Sleepless Nights with another episode on Witness Wednesdays. And go figure, what am I looking at? I'm looking at the same stupid obelisk I've been looking at for a couple of episodes now. So, in the last episode, we finally got the rest of the hex puzzles out of the way, which is good. And they're all inputted into the system thingy. Now, I have to admit, I'm a little bit... just a smidge on the press for time side. I've been having a really rough week in terms of time management. Like, it's not been a bad week, just been busy. And I have been kind of having a lot of hard times finding the time to record some stuff. So, I didn't want to basically do the videos today. Not like this, but like the video down in the video room, the hex puzzle videos. I didn't really want to do those today because it's basically going to be me sitting here for like an hour just listening to them. Blah. And I think I might do that two different ways. I may do... let me know what you guys think about this, because this is kind of up to you guys as far as if you'd rather not listen to the whole thing while I'm solving the puzzle or whatever. I'm thinking of doing, like, a sped-up version of the videos while we do the puzzle side. And then maybe having, like, the latter portion of the episode be, go back and show you the full unedited version kind of thing is what I'm thinking about doing, and that way people that just want to see the puzzles can, and if they don't want to watch the videos, they can get to a certain point and then just kind of end. So let me know what you guys think about that. I'm not sure how I want to tackle that, because no matter how I slice it, if I include the whole video, it's going to be like an hour, which, from what I've been told anyway, everybody keeps saying it's an hour long video. I don't know that for certain, but that's what everybody keeps telling me. Now, on that note, though, I'm pretty sure that's the only one left, is that hour-long puzzle, because the rest of these were all puzzles from the videos, or at least the video room, if they weren't in the video. And I'm thinking this is going to be that one where you go across and come down. I'm pretty sure that's going to be the final puzzle. So I'm thinking these last two on the obelisk are actually not part of that, so we're going to try and do that first. That's what I'm going to try and tackle today. One of which I may have already found via the comments of my last episode. I mentioned before that I thought it was suspicious that this place over here had catwalks and there was sections that were open, and I thought that was kind of fishy. And in the comments of the last video, somebody pointed out this door. That at the right angles, this door almost looks like a circle, and then you could start going. So I'm thinking that's at least the right track, maybe. Because if you follow it, it would kind of go up and around. Well, I don't know. I think they're onto something, though. I'm not sure what. But when I looked at it before, it really made a lot of sense. Like, from certain angle, like right in here, it starts to kind of look like a starting point for a circle or something. But I'm not really getting it from the angles from here. Like, from the areas where we could actually do the environmental puzzle. So I'm wondering if that's not the right point of view to be tackling it from. I'm not sure that we're on the wrong track. I just think we're in the wrong angle? But I don't really know. I don't really know for sure. That does look suspicious to me, but I can't find a spot where that lines up. Also, we should probably double check which way that obelisk side is, because that might be too far over. Okay, so we're looking from this kind of angle, like this way, back towards there. So that could actually be it, I think. Give or take. Maybe you have to go at it from another building. That's a possibility. Oh, I would have to solve that one again. Let's do that real quick. Because beyond that, I'm not really sure, to be perfectly honest. Although... no, maybe not. I was gonna say that looks a little iffy that it kind of ends, like maybe there would be a circle over here you could do, but then it doesn't look like it continues anywhere. So, maybe not. Trying to remember how I did this. I think it's like this. right? Yeah, that fully extends it. So from here, can we get at this doorway or anything? Maybe? No? Hmm. It was a really good idea, though. I really like that idea. Oh, wait a minute. I never really looked over in this kind of stuff, like, from up high on, like, the grass and things. I wonder if maybe that's a thing. Hmm. Lots of possibilities. Lots of possibilities. There's shadows, there's all kinds of stuff we could work with. I don't know. When I first read that comment and came back and looked at this, I found it a lot easier to see the circle in this. Now I'm not so sure. Now after kind of looking at it, I'm not really sure that I'm seeing the circle there. But what concerns me more is the lack of mobility. Like, once you find an angle that you can start the circle, it kind of has to follow from there. And I'm not really seeing a spot where I could just stand and do the whole thing without getting obstructed. So this might not be the right tree to be barking up. I'm not 100% sure. I think... Oh, you know what? I haven't been up here in a while. Maybe there's something from an angle that I missed up here, perhaps. Because I feel like it's going to be something that I haven't really been looking at before, or else I probably would have noticed. I like to think I would have noticed anyway. Maybe I wouldn't have, I don't know. Still going. Nothing here, like underneath or anything. I wonder if maybe this does something at some point, like, because it continues. I don't rightly know. I did this one already, right? Yes, okay. I'm not really sure. We did all of those, right? I mean, this isn't lit. Oh, yes, it is. Never mind. I was going to say that's not lit up, but it kind of is, so that narrows that down. All right, let me go around and take a peek a little bit and see if I can't figure out, see if we can't find where this is. If I work too long and can't find where this actually is, even if we don't work out how, then I will probably move to the other puzzle and see if we can't find that one instead. All right, so bad news and good news. The bad news is I still have yet to find the puzzle in question. Though, just noticing, that's kind of a curious little, like, this is the pose, this is the shadow, kind of makes two different images. Yeah. So, still have not found the puzzle that I'm looking for. I'm really expecting it to be a path or a frame around a bridge, or not bridge, a building or something. But on the good side, I did happen to, in all my looking around, find this little guy.
Oh my god. How does it happen in this poor old world that thou art so great, and yet nobody finds thee? That thou callest so loudly, and nobody hears thee? That thou art so near, and nobody feels thee? That thou givest thyself to everybody, and nobody knows thy name? Men flee from thee, and say they cannot find thee. They turn their backs and say they cannot see thee. They stop their ears and say they cannot hear thee. Hans Denk, circa 1520.
So that was an interesting little tidbit. One thing was, normally these have a view. Now, you could turn around and say this is a view for that. But I, as you can tell, I was kind of looking this way. And I saw... I'm seeing things now. Because I don't think any... Like, half of these can actually be puzzles. There's only one over in this area. But it occurred to me, I wonder... I was looking for something that goes around a building, and I'm wondering if it's going to end up being, like, a plant or something. Like a vine or a tree that's going up and around? I don't know at this point. I keep seeing all these little things, like little tiny windows and stuff, and you're like, what is this here for? Oh, look, there's two? There's two of them.
Imagine if all the tumult of the body were to quiet down, along with all our busy thoughts about earth, sea, and air. If the very world should stop, and the mind cease thinking about itself, go beyond itself, and be quite still. If all the fantasies that appear in dreams and imagination should cease, and there be no speech, no sign. Imagine if all things that are perishable grew still. For if we listen, they are saying, we did not make ourselves. He made us who abides forever. Imagine then that they should say this and fall silent, listening to the very voice of him who made them, and not to that of his creation, so that we should hear not his word through the tongues of men, nor the voice of angels, nor the clouds thunder, nor any symbol, but his very self, which in these things we love, and go beyond ourselves to attain a flash of that eternal wisdom which abides above all things. And imagine if that moment were to go on and on, leaving behind all other sights and sounds but this one vision, which ravishes and absorbs and fixes the beholder in joy, so that the rest of eternal life were like that moment of illumination which leaves us breathless. Would this not be what is bidden in Scripture? Enter thou into the joy of thy Lord. Augustine of Hippo, circa 400.
Augustine of Hippo. I know that's an actual person, just of Hippo. It's just a great name.
It is a great adventure to contemplate the universe beyond man, to contemplate what it would be like without man, as it was in a great part of its long history and as it is in a great majority of places. When this objective view is finally attained, and the mystery and majesty of matter are fully appreciated, to then turn the objective eye back on man, viewed as matter, to view life as part of this universal mystery of the greatest depth, is to sense an experience which is very rare and very exciting. It usually ends in laughter and a delight in the futility of trying to understand what this atom in the universe is, this thing, atoms with curiosity, that looks at itself and wonders why it wonders. Well, these scientific views end in awe and mystery, lost at the edge in uncertainty, but they appear to be so deep and so impressive that the theory that it is all arranged as a stage for God to watch man struggle for good and evil seems inadequate. Some will tell me that I have just described a religious experience. Very well, you may call it what you will. Then, in that language, I would say that the young man's religious experience is of such a kind that he finds the religion of his church inadequate to describe, to encompass that kind of experience. The God of the church isn't big enough. Richard Feynman, 1963.
So, just as a side note, I think it's really funny that they put, like, one audio recording that's like pro-God and one that's like skeptical right next to each other in the same spot. I just think that's really funny, like ironic. One of the things though that I've noticed about these audio logs is they tend to be in places that make you stop and look around, or at least that's kind of the general idea. So I'm kind of trying to stop and look around, but I don't know what I'm looking for. This one puzzle has me rather stumped because I found all the other ones in the immediate vicinity of it, so it kind of tells me where it's supposed to be. but I'm not really sure what I'm looking for. It could be big, it could be small. It's like this one is the bottom of that platform, and this one is the flowers on the side of the cargo container. I'm trying to think. I think all of these were on the underside of the catwalks for the big pillar in the center of the village thing. So it's all kind of in that direction, so it kind of has it wedged between those two. Which makes me wonder if that's what I'm... Like, these things, like it has... That was the one above it, and then that was the one below it. So it's kind of like... Does that mean it's in this area? Is it under here? You know, like, I'm not really sure where I'm looking. I have also wondered if there's not a... For lack of better term, if there's not, like, a different perspective where, like, all of these line up or something in a different fashion of some kind? Maybe? That's kind of what I'm wondering about. Like, this one we got, that one we got. That one needs to be used for something, doesn't it? That's curious. That's very curious. Why have I not used that one for something? Ivanda? Oh, wait. What about... Nope, that won't work. Huh. So that's interesting. This could be a red herring. But it's also possible that it's part of the puzzle that I have not actually found yet, as well. Which is an interesting prospect when you think about it. Okay, so that one's there. Do we use the same one for this guy? Looks like. Okay, that one's there. We did that one already, I think. Didn't we? Yeah, we did that one. That has me very curious as to why this one piece is here. Again, it could literally be just to throw you off. It is possible that they did something to that effect. But it's also suspicious to me. I say it's possible because there's nothing connecting to it or from it, so it kind of makes me wonder... It's like, is there a certain angle it has to be viewed from? I'm kind of erring on the side of it's probably a bait and switch to distract you. But the truth of the matter is I really don't know that for sure. So then it begs the question, is this the puzzle that I've been missing? Because it is kind of in the same direction, considering all the other ones were solved in that manner. I wonder if there's any... in here, even. I don't see any. Or if there's any way to solve them from up here, I don't know. Like, I don't see any water to, like, reflect the thing or something, because I could have seen something like that. I doubt there's more on the underside. I really don't know. I really don't know. It's also possible that it is actually the outline of a building, and I just haven't found the right building yet, too. I'm not really sure, to be honest. Like, just being straight up, I'm not really sure what to make of some of this stuff. I still think that I'm not ruling out that it's a edge of a building or something. Because it just... Some of the... angles really look like you're following up the side of a wall kind of thing. So I haven't given up on that idea entirely. I'm just not finding anything that looks halfway sensible. I even thought about... Wait a minute. Is there something in this from a different angle, I wonder? Because that kind of looks like one right there, but it doesn't really... It's not really set up to go anywhere, though. Oh, wait, there's a green one. There's a green one. I got it. So we gotta change the lights in there. Haha! I have found you. Outwitted you. Green. Was that the middle? Ah! Got it right in the first try. I'm so excited! We found it! Alright, oh, come on. There we go. Boom! It was kind of along the side of a building. Sort of. Maybe. Kind of not really. Okay, fine, it wasn't. It looked kind of like it was, though. Alright, so that should be all but the last puzzle and then the one inside the hour-long video. I'm calling it that again. I don't know if it actually is an hour or not. That's what everyone keeps telling me. Alright, so this one was in the starting area. This one was in the starting area. This was the dock and edge. This was something like the road. This was the hidden exit. This was somewhere... I think this was either the road or the wall. This might have been the wall. So we've got one more, and I'm guessing that's still in the starting area. That would be my guess. I could be wrong. I probably am. But I don't really have any better leads at the moment than to go back to the starting point and see what we can find. Okay, so I'm back in the starting area, and I was trying to kind of look around a bit and see if we could find anything that stood out. Now, this isn't supposed to be a crazy drastic puzzle. It's a very tapered curve kind of puzzle. So I'm not really looking for jagged walls or anything like that. Like, it should be a fairly, like, a flower cloud... maybe even something in the grass or whatever. Like, it should just be a kind of graceful curve, though, not anything super crazy. I'm pretty sure we did the road one already. Yeah, that's the one that was on one of the obelisks already. One of the marked ones. So that's not it. Now, this is kind of curious. This is kind of curious, because you can't get this puzzle from here, I don't think. You have to be on the other side. And yet, you can get up here. And there's cracks in the walls where you can move a little forward. And where most people would say it's just balancing, or... And it might be just to throw you off or something, but to me... It has me curious as to why this is really here. I mean, it might be so that you can see this. I feel like we did the wall one that ran along the edge of the wall. I still think we were over there. So that still doesn't really help. So, like I said, I keep coming back to why is this pathway available in here, if not to serve a purpose? So I'm thinking it serves a purpose, basically. That's kind of my thing. Though, that said... I'm not really seeing anything that stands out to me at the moment. That's going to be the hidden ending one. We've already done that. Now, wait a minute. That kind of looks like it could be a circle from the right angle. And no, I don't actually mean a right angle. maybe not from this one, though. There's a tree in my way here. So that's suspicious. We did that one. Did I miss? Oh, there's an audio here that I missed.
Through many births, I have wandered on and on, searching for, but never finding, the builder of this house.
Wait, is that it? Usually there's like a quote or something at the end, so I was waiting for something and it never really came. Okay, this can't be a coincidence, right? Like, that just... no. And that's also... yeah, that's also kind of a curvy shape. Okay, well now I kind of have an idea of what I'm looking for. I just don't know where it's at. So we have what seems like half of the puzzle. Does it line up up here? It doesn't really line up up here, so maybe that's not where we're supposed to be. So I'm wondering then, do we use the tree line to finish the puzzle? Maybe? Now grant you, I know we did solve that one, but we moved the laser. Did it go back to being gray? Or wait, no, did we move the laser? Maybe we didn't. No, we didn't move the laser. So the gray one's over there. So that's not the same puzzle, though it is possible it's the same pieces. And what I mean by that is that may not be what I'm looking for, because it may in fact be the setup pieces that already have been solved. So I don't know with 100% certainty, but I'm thinking... I am thinking that's what we're looking for. Because that would be a nice little curve shape, which is kind of what we're hunting, I think. So I gotta get down on the ground somewhere, somehow. There we go. And keep an eye on this and see if we can't ever get it to line up properly. I'm seeing the pieces, but I really can't find the other half. That's the problem that I'm looking at right now. Because that definitely seems like all the pieces are there. Oh, well, no, not all the pieces. You know what I mean. Wait a minute. Do we use the castle? Because that kind of looks like a circle. Maybe. Oh, wait. What about you? Yep, there we go. Got it. Boom! Booyah! Booyah. Alright. Now, there is one other option that I could do. I could do a time-lapse type of thing and go ahead and solve the one puzzle in the video. And in fact, I might. And then basically just release that video, or release another episode, because we're probably going to do another episode, at least. So we might want to do that, because that's literally the only puzzle left for solving all the obelisks. But at the same time, I don't know if we're going to get into anything afterwards. So I tell you what, we're going to wrap things up here for this episode. And then the next episode, we'll go down, we'll do the video puzzle, but I may time-lapse it unless I just get a resounding no, just let it play out, we all want to see it. In which case, that's fine, because one way or another, I'm going to have to watch it anyway. Even if I time-lapse it or something. It's a time-lapse for you guys, but I will have had to have watched it at least once just so I can solve the puzzle. So let me know what you guys think about that. Are you okay with watching it, like the next episode being like an hour long plus or something? The other big thing is I don't know what we're going to get into. I don't know what we're going to find when solving the last obelisk. Let me know about that. Don't spoil anything if it's a cool thing. But if you've already completed the game and gotten all the obelisks and stuff, let me know kind of what I'm in for. Is there a long secret ending thing? Does nothing happen? Is it like a pat on the back? Good job, you solved all the puzzles. That kind of bit. So let me know about that in the comments, as far as if I should plan ahead and have time left over to do something like that, or will it not matter? But mostly what I want to know from everybody is, do you want to see the rest of the videos? I had a couple people from the last episode say, you know, I'd like to see all the remaining video clippets and things like that, which is fine. I'm totally down. Like I said, I gotta watch them all at least once just to make sure there's no puzzles in anything. But let me know what you guys think about all that in the comments. In the meantime, I hope you all enjoyed. If you did, leave a like, and I will see you all next time. Peace!